हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू डे 14 ऑफ दिसंबर लीड को चैलेंज। एंड टुडेस क्वेश्चन इज पैलिंड्रोम पार्टिशनिंग। यू आर गिवन अ स्ट्रिंग एस इन दिस क्वेश्चन एंड यू नीड टू पार्टिशन एस सच दैट एवरी सब स्ट्रिंग ऑफ द पार्टिशन इज पैलिंड्रोमिक इन नेचर। यू नीड टू रिटर्न ऑल पॉसिबल पैलिंड्रोमिक पार्टिशनिंग ऑफ एस। लेट्स गो थ्रू वन ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल दैट इज कोटेड इन दिस क्वेश्चन। सो यू आर गिवन अ स्ट्रिंग ए ए बी। वन ऑफ द पैलिंड्रोमिक पार्टिशनिंग ऑफ ए ए बी इज ए अगेन फॉलोड बाय ए फॉलोड बाय ए। So A A B gives us all independently are palindromic in nature, and when you add these numbers all together, you get S as the final string, and hence A A B's palindromic partitioning. One of the possibility is to treat all the characters separately, and you'll get one of such case. The other case is a double A B. If you treat double A as a complete string, which is again palindromic in nature, and the other part would be a separate B. Let's go through the slideshow that I have created, palindrome partition, lead code 131, day 14 of December lead code challenge. Before this, let me just ask you a question. How do you check whether a string is palindromic or not? There is a simple way out. One is the two-pointer approach, where you start from the starting of the string, other is the ending of the string, and you compare both the characters, one at the start, another at the end. And if these two characters are equal, you increment the start one and reduce the end one. Until the time the string is not exhausted, you keep on checking. At any point, if there is a mismatch, you return false. If you have traversed a complete string, then you return true. One way is to solve this way. The other way is a simpler and a smarter way. You simply reverse the string and create a copy of that. And you compare the copy reverse string with the original string. If both of them are equal, you return true, else you return false. For example, A, B, B, A. If you reverse the string, you get A, B, B, A. And when you compare these are equal, so return true. Let's take another example, which is a non-palindromic in nature, A, B, A, B. You reverse the string, you get B, A, A, B, A. And these two are not equal, you return false from it. So let's move ahead with the actual logic. So before the actual logic, let's think about few cases here. For example, let's talk when the string is simply A. What could be the palindromic partition for A? You will get a single string A in the answer. If you have AB, AB is non-palindromic in nature, and there's only one possibility, A comma B. Now we have ABA. There are two possibilities. ABA, all the strings treated separately, and ABA treated collated together as a string. So there are two possibilities to partition ABA. One is to not to partition, another is to partition at two places, this and this. Now let's take the fourth example, ABACFC. So there are four ways to partition this string. First one is to treat all the characters separately. The other one is to partition at this point. So ABA can be treated separately, A comma B comma A, and then followed by CFC. CFC is itself a palindromic string. Or you can do ABA comma C comma F comma C. Also, the fourth possibility would be ABA comma CFC. So these are the four possibilities that we can draw out of this string. Now let's look at the logic. How are we going to solve this? So what we will do, we'll try to partition at each point in this string. So let's partition the string at this point. Let's check whether this string is palindromic in nature. Our I lies at this position. And since this is palindromic in nature, we will recursively iterate through the rest of the string. That means this part of the string. So if this is palindromic, the first part is palindromic. You'll recursively iterate through the second part of the string using the backtracking technique, and whatever possibility that you generate for this part is one of your valid possible answer. Let's move ahead to the next iteration. Now you get AB, you generate the second substring, you partition at this place. So you got AB, and it's not palindromic in nature, so you simply ignore this. This is a bad case. Now you move ahead, ABA. So you got ABA. So that means you partition at this place. Since you are partitioning at this place, what is in the remaining part of the string? CFC. So whatever possibilities you can generate out of CFC will give you another set of possible answers. That's also cool. Then you move ahead with ABAC. So this string, this part of the string, this is non-palindromic in nature, ignore. Then you move ahead, ABACF. This is again non-palindromic in nature, you simply ignore. And the last string is ABACFC. This is again non-palindromic in nature, you simply ignore. So there are only two cases where we found, where we can find possibilities for the answer. One was this case, A plus the possibilities for ABCFC. And the other one was ABA and the possibility for CFC string, this string altogether. So we can recursively do the similar process and find all the possibilities for that answer. And this would be a backtracking technique, a simple backtracking technique to solve this question. So what have you done in this question? You have reduced the problem statement into smaller cases by reducing one string, one index at a time, one portion of the string at a particular time, and generating the possibilities for the remaining part of the string. And you have granularized the problem into sub-problems, and this is how backtracking works. So let's quickly code this up. Typical backtracking approach I'm gonna write. So let me just write a variable that will help us store the result. So this is that variable. And let me just check if string.length equals to 0 or my initial string is null. In either of the case, I need to return an empty result. So I've returned the result. Let me just call the helper method. We are doing in a DFS fashion. So what first parameter would be the result path. The other parameter would be my current list of strings that will store the current palindromic objects. So current list, and the other one would be the string part, so S part. And you simply return result. So let me just write the helper method. So this is our result, list of string. This is my current list of palindromic strings, and this is my input string. So if input string dot length that becomes 0 for any case, that means you have exhausted your input length and this is your possibility of an answer. So what are you gonna do? You will add res dot add new array list comma current. So this parameter stores all the palindromic partitions for the previous string that you have computed, and you've added it to the result because the input string is null. Now you have reached the end of your partition, end of your string, and you simply return back. So this is the abortion case for the recursion part. Otherwise, what are we going to do? We'll start from the 0th index, go till the end of the substring, end of the string, and you will generate the first part of the string as your substring part. So string first part would be given by s.substring. What will be the parameters for this? 0, I plus 1. And if your first part is palindromic, we discussed in that example that the first part has to be palindromic. It's palindrome, first part. If my first part of the string is palindrome, I'll add it to my current set of palindromic list. So current list dot add first part, and but now let me generate the second part of the string. The second part of the string would be s dot substring I comma I plus 1 comma s length till the end of it. and what I'll do, I'll recursively invoke the helper method, res comma current list comma second part, and once we are done with this iteration, I'll remove the last element that we added as a part of the backtracking technique. Current list dot remove the last one we added. Current list dot size -1, and we are done here almost. We just need to define a helper method for palindromic substring. Boolean is palindrome. So string s. How are we going to do this? We'll generate a reverse string. How? Using the string builder function. So string reversed string new string builder. So string builder has a capability, has an inbuilt method to reverse the string, to generate two string, and to simply compare s dot equals reversed string with the reverse string. This looks perfect to me, and let me just try this up. Oops. Let's just write the case that was written in the question. I think I missed a typo here. This is the current list. Sorry for that. Cannot find symbol S. Oops. It has to be input length, not S. So let me just update this quickly. And let's see, where are we? Another compilation error, s.length. Again a typo, apologies for that. Yeah, now we have got the correct answer, and let me just submit this. Accepted.